All right, guys, we are here at CrossFit Chalk, and what I really wanted to do a lot of today was talk about the style of the programming that I do when I do the programming that I make, and then also what I wanted to do was go through a CrossFit workout, go through a sweat workout, go through a daily dumbbell workout that I make that are available on the app for CrossFit Chalk and the Chalk online programming, which has been a massive thing right now around the world. So there's a lot of workouts that I post online. There's a lot of things that other people are posting and tagging me in, but there's not a lot out there really that talks about exactly what I'm thinking about when I make these workouts, or even more specifically, just like, you know, what is each one really targeting and what are we trying to do for each particular program. So the first workout that I'll talk about is CrossFit, and CrossFit means different things to everybody. So every gym is independently owned, which doesn't necessarily mean that we all do the same workouts. So because everyone is independently owned, we get the option of making our own workouts for our own population, and in our own style and our own beliefs and whatever. So some CrossFit gyms love powerlifting and they make that an emphasis of their gym. Some gyms love Olympic lifting and that's an emphasis of their gym. Some gyms love just like hero workouts and just long breathers and just big long conditioning pieces, and people stick to that. So in the beginning days of CrossFit, everybody would put their workouts on their website and you could see what they believed in and what they did every single day. And it kind of gave you the option of which gym you wanted to join in your area. But a lot of times now, people either are not putting their workouts on the website, or if they are, it's either not the whole thing or whatever. So it doesn't really matter at this point. What does matter is the Chalk program, because that's what we're here for today. Here's what we're here to talk about. And I have potentially probably like top three in the world most popular CrossFit program in the world. So with the CrossFit program, for me, my emphasis, what I believe in, what I put on there all the time, is a mixture of powerlifting, Olympic lifting, and bodybuilding. So I believe that the bodybuilding stuff needs to happen every once in a while. Get people in there to do stuff that's not super, super high paced and to work on muscles that make them look good. Because I always tell all my members that your body is my responsibility when you leave my gym. If you don't look good when you leave this gym, it doesn't make the gym look very good. It doesn't make me look very good. It doesn't make it look like I know what I'm talking about, right? So I try very, very hard to make workouts that fill the entire hour in such a way where we have two pieces. There's a strength piece and a conditioning piece. I always have like a 20-minute strength piece and a 20-minute conditioning piece. And it doesn't necessarily mean that it's always going to be 20 minutes long, but I might have like a 5-minute piece times three different sections and there's a rest in between. But I always take up the entire time so that people are working out for at least 40 minutes for every single class. Whereas a lot of other gyms out there, what they'll typically do is maybe just a 20-minute piece and that's it. Maybe there's no strength. Maybe the conditioning piece is just 20 minutes long every day. Maybe they're not really varying the energy systems in people's bodies so they're getting the best results possible. It's very important to alternate between a long day and a short day and a strength day and a cardio day and stuff like that. So when I'm making my workouts, I'm keeping all of those things a priority. All of my strength templates are typically 4 to 6 weeks long because I don't want new members to come in and be in the middle of a 12-week squat program because now they're completely lost. There's really nothing they can do to catch up. And I can't have them start in the beginning because depending on how many new members you get or if someone's been on vacation or whatever, you'd have everybody at different places and it would be a nightmare. So it's important to have short cycles. People get results quick. They get excited real quick. So I always kind of stick to those 4 to 6 week cycles. And then as far as the body parts go, I'm always alternating upper body and lower body parts, incorporating a little bit more core in some sections and then incorporating a little bit more bodybuilding on other sections as well. So that is definitely the most advanced, hardest part of the programming that I do here at Chalk. It's definitely what's put us on the map. But also the other thing that's equally put me on the map is the sweat class. So the sweat class for me is 40 minutes long every day. There is no strength piece in that one. It's only conditioning. I pretty much alternate, same deal, upper body, lower body, majority core. And those workouts either have like little windows of like 6 to 7 minute work blocks, 10 minute work blocks. And then if you finish it early, you get extra bonus rest. So it's kind of like MASH style, or it's just a bunch of different workouts that equal about 40 minutes long. In that class, you have option of picking different weights. I usually bear on the easier side, and then some of the more advanced people will go to the heavier weights on that workout, kind of on their own, and sometimes I put the option in there. The one thing that I don't implement in that class is I do not do strict gymnastics work, or even gymnastics work really in general. I don't do any high skill barbell work in that class. You're not gonna see any snatches, you're not gonna see any power cleans, but you will see dumbbell power cleans, dumbbell snatches. The only thing you will see with a bar is maybe like a front rack lunge, a front squat. We'll do thrusters, but only with the barbell. So my original idea of the sweat class was to give people something that were coming off the street into the gym, something to do right away. Because when I first opened the gym, a lot of gyms had this on-ramp program, or you know, you had to see a trainer, or you had to do something before you can come to class, and I didn't want that. I wanted people to enjoy the class right away and see if it was something they wanted to do, and then offer a class that was harder if once they figured that out, or if they wanted to see a coach or do some sort of on-ramp process. So the sweat class started off intro class for people to come into, get it in, get a good sweat, feel what we're all about, easier movements that they can learn in like 10 seconds or less and get them going. The sweat class became so popular though that now people only want to do sweat. So I definitely put a little bit more time into the programming on that one now. It does not make sense in conjunction with CrossFit. It's its own thing. So Monday through Friday, it has its own flow. CrossFit Monday through Friday has its own flow. And on the sweat workouts, they are always between 36 minutes and 40 minutes long. And they're really, really hard now. So now that I've found that there's a huge population of people who want to do that and they want to stick to just the sweat program, I've made it a lot harder. The weights are a little bit more aggressive, but not on the CrossFit side aggressive. They're just sweat aggressive. And it's definitely its own style, its own workout. It's very, 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 very popular. It's not as friendly off the street as it used to be, but it can be scaled to that level very, very easily. Like, no problem. So I still use it for people off the street, and now I have a lot of people who use it mainly as a fat loss program or weight loss program for themselves. Because like it's called, sweat, you tend to sweat quite a bit in that class. So the last thing I offer is the dumbbell, the Daily D. The Daily D is kind of just a funny thing I wanted to call it because I think it just makes it sound a little bit more fun. But the Daily D is basically a daily dumbbell workout. So whether you're traveling, you're in a hotel gym, you're bringing stuff with you like on a car trip, like a set of dumbbells, or maybe you're at home and you just don't have a lot of equipment, or you're a parent and you don't have a lot of time. Like, all these workouts are usually 20 minutes long. They usually don't typically go over 20 minutes long. At the highest end, it'll be 30 minutes. And they only need a set of dumbbells, a barbell, not a barbell, what is wrong with me? A set of dumbbells, a pull-up bar, and a jump rope. So that's it, that's all you need. You just need a pull-up bar so you can do pull-ups and toes to bar, and then set of dumbbells and a jump rope, and you're good to go. So if you're traveling, you just bring a jump rope with you. You're gonna have dumbbells in all your hotel rooms. If you're traveling in your car or something like that, you can bring a set of dumbbells, no big deal. And those workouts, they're a little bit harder to keep variety-wise throughout the week, but I can pull it off. So I have 6 workouts a week on the Daily D workout. There's one rest day that's mandatory, and then there's another day of the week I call it Adventure Sundays. And it's usually like a swim, a run, or a bike workout that I recommend for the day. So nothing with weights at all, just outside getting it in. And yeah, those are my 3 programs that I offer on the app. There's a workout every single day. You have 3 workouts to choose from, obviously. You have 3 goals to choose from, obviously. 3 different types of equipment to choose from. And, you know, if you have a hard time figuring out what you're going to do when you go to the gym, it's a great thing to have in your pocket and be able to see, you know, tons of different workouts at any given time. So when you guys go on the app, so this is the Daily D workout for today. And I can just switch this here and go to the other programs. I have sweat, CrossFit, and every time I do that, it'll just switch the workout up, give me a new workout, and I can change the date. So I have access to all these workouts. I can click up here and I can check out workouts from the past months, the past years. Once you buy this app, it's $20 a month and you have access to 5 years worth of workouts that I've made. Every workout that I've made in the last 5 years in the gym for all the programs. So that's pretty cool. So what I like to do is sometimes I call it chalk roulette. So I go on there, click a date, and just kind of spin it and have it land on something. And then when me and the guys want to do a workout, whatever it lands on, that's pretty much it. So ends a lot of just unnecessary conversation. So yeah, guys, that's some of the things I'm thinking of when I'm making the program. I'm constantly try to make things that people are constantly moving. There's not a lot of things where, you know, I do a lot of big chippers where it's 100 reps of this, 100 reps of that, 100 reps of this, and you're sitting there and you kind of get bored and, you know, it doesn't seem like you're moving that fast. And you're not, actually. And a lot of competitions, they'll do stuff like that to find the fittest person. That's fine. But when it comes time to you being in my gym and your body going outside and me being responsible for it and what you look like, I try to keep stuff where your heart rate is constantly high. I only have you for 40 minutes, right? I have 20 minutes to get you warmed up. I have 40 minutes to get you the best workout that I possibly can. So in that 40 minutes, I am making stuff purposely in such a fashion that is giving you the best calorie loss, the best muscle gain in my 15 years of experience of doing this. So I promise you right now, if this is something that you decide to do, you will absolutely love it. And I tell everybody, if you don't like it, I will gladly give you your money back anytime. But I don't want this to be a sales pitch. I just want you guys to know what I'm doing over here in the gym and why I do it. So what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna do all the workouts for today, the CrossFit, the sweat, and the Daily D, just to show you guys what they look like, show you what they're all about. And yeah, you guys let me know what you think of them. So a lot of people out there are always asking questions about warm-ups. The warm-up really should just be either something specific to you, whether it's, you know, you gotta work on your shoulder mobility or your knee mobility or your ankle mobility, but just going through the movements that you're gonna do with an empty bar and then a little bit of weight, a little bit more weight, and doing a little bit of cardio on the machine that you're gonna use. It's all you need to do. Everybody makes this so complicated and they get so stressed out about the fucking warm-up, and in reality, it's just everything you're gonna do at 30%, at 50%, at working weight. That's it. It's all you need to do. I get so mad about that shit. This is the new whoop, by the way. It just came out today.
What are your features?
It's got a heart rate monitor now, so you can see where your heart rate's at while you're working out. It's pretty cool. And the strap is like super legit now. It used to move around a lot on your wrist. Now it's just, it's pretty stuck on there actually now. It's pretty good. I had the other whoop for probably a little over a year. I just got this one yesterday. I don't think it's even out yet actually for everybody else. They sent me like a prototype. So yeah, I really love it. But I think it's gonna be out by the time this video comes up. It should be out. Definitely a great way to see how hard you're going on the workouts. It'll tell you, like, it'll give you a number on how hard you normally train and let you know if you went, like, not that hard or if you went super hard on the workout that day. And then when you get sleep and you wake up the next day, it'll tell you how much you recovered. It's pretty cool. If you like to geek out on stuff like I do, it's definitely another fun little thing to have in your life. It's, like, almost as important to me as an iPhone at this point. So, most of the stuff that I do in the gym is gonna have that added weight factor because I'm aware that not for everybody a 15-20 minute warm-up is enough. So D4B is a little older clientele, average age by 35. So probably need a little more warm-up. So what I like to do instead of giving people heavy weights right off the bat and maybe not pushing themselves as much as they should, I put the option of, I call it climbing. So you climb in weight each round. And that's another reason why the rest break is the way it is. It gives you a little bit of time, switch it up, and if there's a big class, have a little alternating start times. But physiologically speaking, that 90 seconds rest is enough time for your body to get rested enough so you can repeat a heavy set. It's very rare you see a professional bodybuilder doing AMRAPs, right? They always have that rest break so they can come back and lift the heavy weight. AMRAPs are good because you're accumulating volume in a
that short period of time, you're building muscle for sure, but being able to repeat heavy weights builds a little bigger muscle. Finished the CrossFit workout. I wanted to show you guys a sweat workout that I'm gonna do today. We did this one last week, but the one that I have on the program for today, it complements a little bit of the CrossFit stuff, so I didn't wanna overlap movements, but I want you to see how this one rolls. And 35 minute chipper. If you get through it, great. You can stop. If you get through with a lot of time left, because you're a freak, you can go back through. These are 50 reps. You can go back through at 25 and then stop at the 35 minute mark. So I give everybody in the gym the option of being able to finish and be done or keep going, because some people, you know, they have a bad weekend, they eat some pizza, they drink a bunch of beer, and they're like, they want to punish themselves. So I commend you for that, and you can go through and do 25. But what we're going to do right now for this video is I'm going to go through one time. I'm going to go 50 reps of everything. We got pull-ups, wall balls, calorie row, push-ups, double unders, kettlebell swings, box jumps, and then straight back down in reverse order. So you pyramid to the box jump and then pyramid back out. This is a non-stop workout, guys. This is keep moving. And in my gym and people online, this is everybody's favorite style of workouts, the good old chipper. It's long, it's nasty, you can see the end, and as you chip away, I don't know, there's something about it, you just get a little bit more excited each time as each movement goes by. So let's hit it, see how excited I can get on this workout, even though we just did a CrossFit workout. But I'm here to show you all the things. Cause this is YouTube, motherfuckers. That was three workouts, three very different style workouts, three very different pieces of equipment needed, three very different goals, and obviously you would never do all three of those in the same day, because I'm completely and utterly dead. but as you can see, the different styles definitely have, you know, a different purpose in mind, so it's good to decide what it is that you want to do and to stick to it. In the gym here in Orange County, I have like diehard CrossFitters that will do sweat 1 or 2 days a week on the days that their body is kind of feeling like they want to work out, but they don't want to beat themselves down with some heavy weights. So they'll do the lighter, a little bit more longer duration sweat class to kind of, you know, get their fix in, but not to the point where they're super sore the next day and they're like dead. So these are people that are working out probably 5 to 6 days a week. Personally, for me, I know a lot of you guys are wondering what I do. And I only work out 5 days a week, I promise you that. Probably 3 to 4 out of those 5 days are just one session, and 1 to 2 of them are double days. And my double day is not like a hard second session. It's usually probably 30 minutes long, and a lot of it usually is just lifting. Like I might just do a bunch of conditioning in the morning. There might be a barbell or something heavy in there, but then later on I might do like arms, just like some aesthetic stuff, or I might just do an ab only type of a little workout, like with GHDs, toes to bar, stuff like that. That's actually another YouTube I want to do. It's just a whole day of abs with Ryan Fisher, so that'll be coming soon. But yeah, that's kind of what a typical day looks like in the gym. Pick one of those workouts. We have different time slots throughout the day where you can hit each one of those things. And if you're traveling and you're a CHALK member, you have access to the Daily D everywhere you go, wherever you go. So in the gym, everybody, you know, has to abide by class times. Out there in the world, people who are doing CHALK online or whatever, some of them working out in 24-hour fitnesses, Gold's gyms, all different types of gyms. Some of them have their own garage gym, and some of them just have all sorts of different setups. So it works for a lot of people out there, and I have thousands of people on the program that do it just fine. So the other thing that we have available is the leaderboard. So if you're not really sure what weight to use, or you're not really sure how far you might get on a workout, you can look at the whiteboard on there and look at the scores of the day and compare your score to what someone else got, or at least see what's possible or see what the worst time is and don't get that one. So there's a lot of great things that are on the app, and for $20, it's priceless, really. You have 5 years of my workouts that have taken me hundreds or thousands of hours to really accumulate. And if you're a personal trainer or you're a gym owner or something like that, this is like completely just the biggest value like of all time. but again, I'm not here trying to sell that. I just really want you guys to see what we do here in the gym because the gym is so popular and my own training has been so popular that I just wanted you guys to kind of see a day of it and see what we're doing in here. All those workouts were today's workout. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed another day in chalk, another day working out with me. Some background behind some of the workouts and, you know, just a little bit of knowledge of some of the things that I provide and some of the things that people are following on a daily basis when you see me tagged all over Instagram for different workouts. So there's a little bit more information about what those workouts are. And I will see you guys again next week. I just want to thank Whoop one more time. I've had their watch now for over a year and they sent me the new one. And I think they're going to, you know, start sponsoring the YouTube channel, which is really cool because it's something I never really expected. I just kind of liked their product and now it's something that they want to invest in. They want to invest in me using their product. So I really do dig it. And like I said, it's kind of as important as my iPhone these days. I look at it just as much as I look at my phone. And if you guys want to get one of these things, they actually gave me a code for you guys. It's pretty convenient. The code is FISH, F-I-S-C-H, like my last name, all capital letters. And you guys can get a little discount on this guy. I can't remember what the discount is, honestly. But any discount is better than none. And I don't think anyone's really getting discounts on these things right now. So check it out. Do some research on it. I think there's a money-back guarantee. I think. If not, whoop, I'm sorry. But yeah. Next week, subscribe, like this shit, share it to all your friends, tag me on Instagram, jimryan.com, that's G-Y-M-R-Y-A-N.com, my whole life's on that motherfucker.